Let me know when you all can see my screen, please.
Yes, we can see.
Okay, excellent. Okay, so firstly, a very, very good morning to everybody. Good afternoon to anyone joining from any other time zones. I'm extremely, extremely happy that I have been given this platform to address to the young minds, because your career journeys is actually all about this. And I would really want to thank for this wonderful opportunity to speak, because I think it's a very important day as we are moving towards, you know, the completing 72 years of independence. It is important that the youth who are part of this webinar today, they need to understand that the reason why we are doing these webinars today is because you people will have to give a stronger, a more creative India to the world. And I think there's an immense potential which India has for doing this. I think you all are very promising youth. All that is needed, and as Professor was saying in the beginning of this webinar session, that all that is needed is the right mindset. If you all can nurture yourself to the right mindset, I think you all would be able to do a wonderful job in, you know, building a much stronger India. So today's webinar session, as I was told by Dr. Majumdar, is on women entrepreneurship. But frankly, for me, I think in today's world, with the kind of support that is being given, women entrepreneurship should really not be differentiated from men, but it is actually for the women to come out. I think it is more a problem from the woman's end, that we are a bit hesitant in understanding our own capabilities before we try to build value in this world. We are really going through extreme, unprecedented times, where we really do not know what is happening, be it at the administrative end, research end, medical scientists. Everyone is groping in the dark, because we are not understanding what is in front of us. And we know that, you know, what is happening is something we had never thought of. But what is important is to come out of that crisis. So I will start up this presentation with a warm-up slide. Please see this slide very carefully, and then we move on. You all can see the video?
Yes, we can see.
Okay, good. So what you see in this video and the images is of a corner of the world where I am staying now in Norway, where I was extremely amused, if I can say, to see the harsh conditions in which the winter is spent here. And the most important thing, and I call it as business as usual in unusual circumstances, because I was surprised to find that in spite of all these hurdles in terms of, you know, the natural calamities they have to face in terms of snowstorms and many others, the flights always run on time, even if there is a 5 meter of snow. The children go to school. And I mean, this picture is a very recent one, you know, in July, where it was 32 feet of snow in the month of July. And that is, of course, because of the climate change. But in essence, what I am trying to tell you young people is that please do not think that this is the end of it. Please do not think that, okay, if I am not ending up with a career in this time in a good MNC, then it is the end of the world. No, it is not. You will have to take this as an opportunity. And you young people will have to make this business as unusual to the business as usual. So what I would say in my words is, you please turn this COVID crisis into an opportunity. And the University of Kalyani, like your VC told in the beginning of this webinar, has given you an immense platform. It's not easy to, you all should consider yourself lucky actually to have got such a platform where the Career Hub and Entrepreneurship is giving you all the opportunities you need. All you need is to now bend your future towards a brighter one. And how you would do it is through a lot of things. Reena covered some wonderful tips, extremely valuable ones, which you should remember. But what I have done is taken a step back to tell you that you all are not in a very weird situation, as is being said by the media or as is our own perception towards this COVID crisis. Women or men should be able to understand that people have come out with the best solutions during these times of crisis. So I took a step back, going way back when technology was almost not existing, as a time when Florence Nightingale, we will not see her name much as a woman entrepreneur, but what she did, and the reason I took her name out of the many other people who are women entrepreneurs, even in those times, is because of how she introduced the culture of hand washing. So we all know, you know, like how to wash our hands is something we actually discovered in a new way. You know, there were so many videos, etc., going around where we were being told by even Sachin Tendulkar, like heroes, telling us, look, this is the way you should wash your hands. And we were like, okay, were we doing all the wrong things till now, etc.? So she introduced the culture of hand washing. She actually went against the wishes of her parents and went for nursing as her to build her career. And when she did her nursing and came back, one thing which she, when she got the exposure, she found was that people were dying. There was a high mortality rate, you know, and that is not because the medical science was so much behind, but it was because there were a lot of doctors, but the hygiene culture was missing. So this is just a very small example of how someone individually, just through an idea, you know, like there was someone who asked, like, what idea is good? There is no good or bad idea. It is an idea which is relevant. That is what matters in today's world. So if in your Nadia district, like I was hearing about the flowers or the mangoes being abundant, what you need to see is not something what Mark Zuckerberg has done. You have to see what is the need of people around you, identify that need, and then scale it up. So that is exactly what she did. She first identified the problem in her place when there was a lot of wars happening. There were a lot of casualties. They as nurses had to take care of them. And then she slowly promoted nursing as a profession. And we all know in today's world, in it's the medical people who are the most, almost being looked up to as gods because of what they are doing in a relentless way, in a selfless way. I go to the next example again, which is an example from India, Dr. Kiran Majumdar Shaw. I am not sure how much the media has really covered. Woman from India who recently got the award for the EY World Entrepreneur of the Year. And that is a very, very big milestone for her. And it should be an inspiration for the women. All of you who are listening today in this webinar, please note it is possible. She started from a very basic level. She started it from a garage in Bangalore, in her rented apartment, not even her own apartment, in her rented apartment. And she had all the problems that we all face in today's world. She started with a shortage of funding. She started with a lack of qualified workers. All she had was that intent in her that I will be able to perform. I will do this because India needs this and there is a need for this. So she, I'm not sure if how many of you are aware, actually Biocon has been using one of the medicines which has been useful. Of course, there is some controversy also related to it, but there is a lesson from that thing in the COVID times. What she did was she realized that, you know, if she goes into making of a vaccine or a medicine, it is not a short-term thing. Oxford, for example, is still struggling and wants to be very sure before it's out for the public. So what she did was found a workaround. What she did was there was some medicine which was for cirrhosis. I'm not an expert, so I don't think I want to use the terms. But the fact is what she did was she adapted there was some, she didn't build anything new. What she did was she took something which was existing, and that is because of her intent. That is her mindset. Her mindset made her think, what can I do to save the lives of people? And that is where it is not all about women entrepreneurship, but like you can see in my slide, it is about social woman entrepreneurship. That is one of the trends in today's world. If you really want to be successful, go with the mindset of not making money. Go with the mindset of doing something good for the society. You will see everything else will fall all automatically into place. You will see your entrepreneurship is being appreciated by all. Why? Because people will be able to actually connect with what you are providing as a solution. There is a very famous quote from Kiran, which says, the greatest opportunities often rise at the toughest times. And that has been my experience throughout my entrepreneurial journey. I've highlighted the part she even before has said, toughest times. So this is not the toughest times. And always look for greatest opportunities to arise. You all should consider yourself fortunate that you have this opportunity to use your creative skills to innovate and give solutions to the world. So, when we talk about entrepreneurship, there are a lot of definitions because I know here there are students who need to be motivated, you know, to take up entrepreneurship. I thought I'll just take up some key words which you can correlate with. So there are some things which I give a lot of importance to, which is strategy. A process which was similar to what Nina was saying, you know, it's the execution which matters. You can have a brilliant idea, but it can fail because of the lack of execution. And that is where the process part is important. The information, collecting information. She talked about research, if you remember in her session. Try to collect information, set your objectives, set your vision. Very important, a short-term vision and a long-term vision. If you immediately jump into a long-term vision, you may feel, a bit dejected. You may feel what is happening, but take small steps and slowly move forward. I think that makes life easy and it makes you enjoy what you are doing. Don't just be a part of the race. Oh, everyone is making millions of dollars. I should also run after it. No, just have conviction in what you are doing. Be convinced that, yes, my idea is great and I will make it happen. I think the rest will automatically take its own pace. And last but not the least is the organization skills, which has become very important. Like, you know, with everything becoming digitized in today's world, it is very important how you manage everything, be it the capital funding or be it your resources, be it your customers. And it will be a challenge for you because you will have less of face-to-face and more of things to be done digitally over phone, over internet, over calls, etc. The second part, and that is what I have stressed and I strongly believe in, which is the social entrepreneurship. That is where some very key words to remember are giving good, giving a solution that actually brings a transformation for the good of the society. Just remembering these will do. In a nutshell, this is the screenshot. Which will help you to register in a very short way. What is it? It is something which is related to a social cause by creating products, services, or solutions. And for whom are you doing it? Who are your target? To bring a change in human lives. And these human lives could be your neighbors, your municipality, your town, your city, or your state, or your country. And then scaling that up to the global levels, or it could be social, environmental, or cultural. Some examples which I noted during these COVID times was, there was one company which was into handicrafts, yeah. And when they understood that, okay, this is not the time when people will really buy my handicrafts, that's not the mindset or mood of the people, they immediately shifted with those same skill sets. They reskilled and upskilled to starting making the masks, very much relevant in today's world. And what they did was being adaptive. There was another company which was not doing well in selling bicycles. But what they took as a risk was to immediately grab the opportunity. They started renting the cycles for sending the first kids, groceries, medicines to different places because there were not enough vehicles, communication options during the lockdown times. Third was, we all know that there was a complete breakdown of the supply chain management. So there were many people, and this is more for the people with the computer background out here in this platform webinar, is they tried to make solutions which would help to bring back the supply chain management process. And how? Through mobile solutions, where you are able to gather a lot of people and get the right people to the right locations for delivery. Like one example I'm giving because we are short of time, but this is one thing they did. So what each of these examples which I'm trying to say actually hint at how the entrepreneur spirit is built in a time of crisis. So women entrepreneurship, the general perception, if you see, is that women are not very forthcoming. And I do agree with this. But the facts actually say otherwise. It's 38% of social ventures are now led by women. And I believe it is because these are the women who are sensitive to the problems. If you address a problem being sensitive, then I think the chances of you leading a successful social venture becomes easier. And that is a very small section, because twice as many men than women are in the conventional business. But women would perhaps, I don't take me on this, this is based on what I have felt from my research, most women tend to be good if they take up social ventures. The other part is what has been seen during the COVID times is women-led healthcare startups are leading the pack in designing response to coronavirus pandemic, which could be in various ways. I touched upon a few of them. Women-led companies have a track record of strong return on investment. So usually when men are going to, for the funding, they are asking for millions of dollars, etc., to start their work or give it a shape. But women are very shy when it comes to asking for money. But when it comes to performing or, taking their venture forward, then they give a lot more importance to a strong return on investment. And I think you all will have to really give more importance to this fact when you are actually pitching, to show that you will be consistent, and what you want to tell them is you understand finance. And if that is there, then I think there would be an appreciation from the funders. Female entrepreneurship stimulated the economy after the Great Recession. This was 2007 till to 2012. It continued. And this is something which, again, will not find much of highlight, but this is something based on proper research done, where in USA, there was the woman business, woman-owned business, during the period 2007 to 12, actually generated 1.8 million jobs. The men-owned business, on the contrary, ended up losing 800,000 jobs overall. So there was one question, I think, which said that what are the qualities you look? I think for the women entrepreneurship, and of course, again, I would say it also definitely applies to the men, but they already have some very good qualities like, being aggressive, being not so shy, being more confident. Those are qualities which men already have. So they are a bit ahead already in the race. But what there are some qualities on which women come up uncompromisingly, which is the integrity, extreme hard work, their very good organization skills, their creative problem solving skills. So I would say this way, that I think men would be much better when they come to, ideations, because their networking skills are very good. But they are talking to people, so they have more ideas flowing in. But for women, these qualities, the integrity, hard work, organization skills, creative problem solving, decision making, these are very, very valuable qualities which will help you to move ahead.